Dear students, how are you? Socrates once said, "An unexamined life is not worth living." This is what we are going to examine today or reflect today. An unexamined life is not worth living. Yes, you need to examine yourself to know who you are. Okay? Now, who are you? When somebody is asking you this question, who are you? We say our name. We say our age, nationality, religion, the address, our parents' names, and all that is there in our ID card, you know, which college or which school. Everything that is there in our ID card or Aadhaar card, which gives our identity, is all what we are. With that, it stops. Now, this everybody can say, because everybody has got an ID card in some way or the other. Okay, suppose you don't have anything of these, then who are you? There is something more deep within. That is called examining us or searching ourselves. Like, what are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? What are your value system, your belief system, and your skills, your qualities? How much are we able to say? When I ask you, what is your skill set? If people start thinking, or when I say, ask, what are your strengths? I've seen many times students, they keep start thinking, they are not very sure of what their strengths are because they have not examined themselves. Now this is something very important that we have to do, because that becomes our true identity. That only helps us to keep a mark in this earth. Okay, we need to define ourselves. If we don't do that by examining, if we don't define ourselves, somebody else will define us. Looking at our behavior, somebody else will define our personality, and we start accepting that, and we become so. But that is not the real you. You understood? That is not the real you. Many times I've seen students, they are, this is not their personality, because at very crucial time I can see they are very soft natured or they are very studious people and everything, but then they are carried away by what the others are telling about them, and that decides their personality. So this is a very big danger or a crisis, because when we don't know about ourselves and somebody else is telling who we are and we follow that, we are actually losing our identity, which is a big crisis. Okay, so that should not happen. So how to examine yourself would be the next question. Okay, how to define yourself? I would like to say that there are Johari window, you must have heard, right? There are four quarters, there are four areas that we have to think of. Okay, the first area is that I know and others know. So there are certain areas in my life that I know and others also know, like basically about our identity, as I said, our name and address and basic things. Okay, this is good, but then many a times there are certain areas where I know but others do not know. There are certain things like that. That is, it is very secret to myself. Only I know I am such a person. Outside I am laughing, but inside I am really crying. That nobody knows, and there is a pain in me. Only I know. So there are the secrets in my life. It comes to the second quadrant. Okay, and the third quadrant is that I do not know, but others know about me. How's that? See, I mean, there are certain times when our friends say that you are like this, you are like that, you are such a wonderful person, you are such a creative person, and we think, am I a creative person? So what made the other person tell like that? Or maybe my behavior is like that, or maybe what I did looks to them like I am a very creative person. So I mean, this third quadrant, we have to find out from others, and that will help us to know more about ourselves. Okay, so sometimes maybe there will be a criticism. We think we are perfect, but then the others say you are a double-edged person. You say something yesterday, you say something today. So then we come to know, is it so? Then I have to correct myself. So the third quadrant helps us to improve on ourselves and correct ourselves. Okay, and there is something called a fourth quadrant, which is superb. That is, I do not know and others also do not know. How can we define this? How do we know this basically at all? I do not know, others also do not know. Okay, This is real examination of yourself. Okay, now how to find out this hidden area? Johar Aurobindo says that this is called hidden area or blind spot. Okay, this is totally blind to everyone, but we need to dig out. How? We need to explore. We need to venture out into areas that we have not ventured so far. That means we have to come out of our comfort zones. We are very good in doing certain things. Sometimes I do not want to do certain things. Such areas I have to try out and see. It may be hard, but I have to try out and see. Only when we try out and see, maybe we will know that I am good in that also. Otherwise, how do you know your hidden skills and your strengths? So you have to come out of your comfort zone and you will have to try out and see whether these things I am able to do or not, whether I am good in this or not. Don't judge yourself that I'm not a good singer, or I'm not a good writer, or I'm not a good person. Maybe you have not tried at all. So as and when you get any opportunity, just plunge into it. It may not be easy. That's why I said it will be easy for everyone to be in their own comfort zones. But you have to come out and you have to try it out and see. Initially, you may fall. People might look at you and insult you or criticize you and say, any need for you to come? Why should you come? But then you'll have to try out and see. And then you might know that you are good in many, many, many areas. This is how you'll have to explore the unexplored area. That is called real searching. Okay, so only when you are young, you can actually do this. As you become older, you will always be more comfortable to be in the comfort zone. So this you have to take effort to use all the opportunity and to push yourself. Then you can see this is a new you. This is a new person. This is not the person whom you yourself thought. Now this is how you'll have to examine yourselves. This is what Socrates said. An unexamined life is not worth living. I also would like to conclude by telling one famous quote by Helen Keller. She said, life is either a daring adventure or nothing at all. We know about the story of Helen Keller, what lot of trials she had, what lot of difficulties. But she ventured as a daring adventure and then she has come top of all. Okay, so either you have to venture into it as an adventure, that's called adventure. Okay, or it is nothing at all. So take life like that and try to venture into areas, new possibilities, and find out what more things are there in you. Okay, so wishing you all the best for that. Once you do that, your confidence level will increase by leaps and bounds, which will help you give success in everything that you do. Try it out and see. Okay, so keep doing, and thanks for watching. God bless.